So, Coach, I mean, how fast did all this come about for you?
Well, it came fast. As soon as I heard that there was a possibility that Mike Silva might be leaving, I started reaching out. Like I said, this has always been a job and a place that's been super, super intriguing to me. And so, yeah, as soon as I found out that, I started probably wearing JT out. But, yeah, the process has gone quick.
Being at LSU last year, did that expose you maybe to something that you haven't seen before yet in your coaching profession? Or 22 years, does that pretty much cover, you know, the bulk of it?
Well, no, I can tell you that, you know, the mass majority of that time being on the West Coast, the LSU thing is different, I think, probably than most places in the country, with the following and the support that they get, and the SEC, that thing, that grind is totally different than anything I'd ever seen in college baseball, and it was a tremendous experience to have gone through that.
Having been so close to Thibodeau, what started to, I guess, be the perception of Nicholls baseball to you, and maybe what attracted you to this position?
Well, I think that goes back. I mentioned in my press conference that we played here in 2014, and that this place has really been really attractive ever since then to me. You know, we played Nicholls this year on a Tuesday at Alex Box. We knew that they were a regional type team at that time, and Coach Silva had done such a good job that really it was like, man, whoever gets the opportunity to jump in after him is going to be fortunate, because he's done an incredible job building this thing.
I know you said you wanted to recruit, you know, major league talents that have sort of been under the radar. Is that kind of what you see from the talent that a place like Nicholls has attracted?
Well, yeah. I mean, I look at the roster. I mean, Edgar Alvarez is definitely a guy that I think will have a future in professional baseball, and you know, watching him play, I mean, I have no doubt that he has an opportunity, a shot to make it to the big leagues. I felt the same thing about Parker Cadu. I talked about that during the season. He was one of the top three shortstops or four shortstops that we saw all year, including the SEC. So, and I know those were guys that came in that weren't like blue chip roster guys that came in and they put their head down and they went to work. And so, yeah, those are the kind of guys that we need to continue to get and continue to develop.
Recruiting obviously been a strong suit of yours. What do you enjoy most about that process? And I know relationships is something you said you enjoyed building. What do you enjoy most about the recruiting aspect of the game?
Well, I love the evaluation side of it. I've always enjoyed that. I do love the relationship side of it. My wife was talking about this earlier this morning. You know, I get pretty involved with those kids in a relationship. So when they choose to go somewhere else, sometimes that cuts deep and it hurts, because I really only recruit kids that I want to be around and kids that I feel like I have a good rapport with. And so yeah, so that's probably, I would say, the best part of the whole thing for me.
Go ahead, buddy.
Coach, at LSU, you guys really aced the transfer portal and bringing in impact players from the transfer portal. How do you kind of bring that mentality now with
the— Yeah, I think there's a definite path with the transfer portal here. It's obviously a different path than probably LSU, which is fine. But there's a lot of kids out there that are looking for an opportunity. And so it's our job to turn all those stones over and to evaluate all those kids and to make judgment calls on kids on whether they would fit our system or not, and then going and trying to get them. And then obviously, I think we can land some of those higher end blue chip guys that have Louisiana ties for whatever reason it doesn't work out in the SEC or whatever. So.
You talked about how much Mike Silva has done for this team over the last 2 years, but what are you hoping to bring here that Nicholls doesn't have right now?
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to build on top of it. So, you know, my vision, Mike was here for 3 years. He went to two regionals. You know, that's incredible. He's one of the best baseball coaches in college baseball, in my opinion. But my goal would be to take that a step further and to get through a regional and get into the super regional round and make a run. So that's the next goal, I think.
What excites you about this job? Is it, you know, I guess the opportunity and the potential that comes with this? Does that really excite you about taking this job?
Yeah, obviously the opportunity, the potential, all of that is super exciting. The community, like I said in the press conference as well, like this place is feels different to me. It's a place that I've got two little boys that I can raise my kids and so, you know, in a probably a different environment, you know. I mean, boys can run around the field and run around the campus and probably be okay, whereas I don't know that I'd want to do that in Baton Rouge necessarily. Not because it's a bad place, but just the small town environment. I'm excited for that.
You talk about applying for this job the first go around. What? Just talk about this opportunity now, just to be in the head coach, to run a program now. I'm sure you're excited about that opportunity to finally take over and run a program.
100%. Yeah. I mean, that's always been my goal, is to be a Division I head baseball coach. So. So I'm super lucky. You know, I think, you know, you can always hindsight's 50-50. You know, I can probably look back and see that, you know, I probably wasn't completely ready 3 years ago. So there's no doubt that spending the last year in Baton Rouge at LSU with Coach Johnson and that coaching staff, who, you know, I'll say, in my opinion, maybe the best ever coaching staff in college baseball history. So being around those guys and being around that program and seeing how things were run, I think that really helped develop me and prepare me for this job.
Coach, you see a lot of new coaches take over losing teams, but what's the benefit to taking over a team that has been winning a lot the last 2 years?
Well, you can use that in recruiting. You know, I'd probably need to look and see, but there's not a ton of mid-major programs that I would assume that's been to back-to-back regionals, so you can use that in recruiting, and obviously you can sell the fact that you can do that here because it's been done. So that's huge, and then just the winning culture that comes with winning and going to NCAA regionals, you know, culture breeds culture, and so that's a great thing.
Offensively, Nicholls has been one of the best schools in the country the last couple of years. Pitching-wise, they struggled at times. So is that kind of high on the list of things to kind of change once you get in?
100. Well, you know, I've always said, and I'll die by this, but championships are won with pitching, defense, and timely hitting. So yeah, I mean, we're going to try to get the best arms we can get. You know, it's tough to beat a good arm. So. Yeah, we're going to put a huge emphasis on pitching and defense, and we'll try to continue to roll the success on the offensive side, too.